Hello, my brothers and sisters on the Dragon's Path. My name is Tim Heye and I believe in dragons. Welcome in the Belgian forests again, once more, because I love to be here. Here I can sense Tiamat, my dragon goddess, very, very well, very high. I always, yeah, it's like she's just walking just next to me. And that is what a lot of people have troubles with, that I call her my goddess. She is my goddess. She is a dragon goddess. And she is the mother of all dragons. She is, yeah, the first one. And she had children very easy. And one of these children were, yeah, your guardians, your draconic soul. They are all her children. That is why she's very concerned. And she's still a mom, a mother. A mother of all dragons. A mother of all draconic energy and all draconic spirits. But yeah, a lot of people seem to have a problem that I call her my goddess. But yeah, that is how I see it. She laid herself down on this world. She was sunking into the earth, and everything that grows is still her body, is still her life force. She was creating everything. And she was creating because this was her life force. She didn't even do much effort to create this life. It just came out of her body, because she had children very easy, so life started to be created on her body, you can say, and her blood as well. As the blood is dragon's blood, I mean, the dragon's blood is water, simply. And water, what does water and the earth itself if all of the elements come together, it creates life. Of course, I don't believe in a Christian God. I don't believe in the Christian demon or devil. I don't do it anymore. But in the beginning, of course, I was a skeptic, of course. I was actually an atheist. I used to be a Christian, I'm an atheist, and now I'm on the dragon's path. And I believe in gods. that is what was... To convince me, you have to do a lot of effort. But I was convinced of this goddess. And I was also convinced of the other dragon gods, but I am awakened by her. I was visited by her. And so... I probably say sometimes even a bit too probably, say to everyone, I believe in the dragon goddess, and I believe that she's by my side. And then they say, how many beers did you have to say something like that? Well, I don't know. Some people believe that a guy stood up from the dead after 3 days. What is more strange, to believe in the dragon or to believe in something like that? I mean, sticks that turn into snakes. I mean, what? I don't believe in things like that. I just believe in nature. Nature, where I believe in. The embodiment of nature is the dragon. That is very ancient. You don't have to look it up. I mean, yeah, you can look it up because this is history. Dragons used to be worshipped and they were seen as the elements of nature. And Tiamat of the Mesopotamian Tiamat was one of them. Even the gates of Babylonia even described the dragon. That was the son of Tiamat. Even the story said that the son of Tiamat was brought into the temples of Tiamat. And this dragon, this little newborn dragon, was worshipped. And until a new Christian, Christian was new back in the day, in that time, was strangling the beast. I mean, that was what it said. It's not a beast, it's a dragon. He was strangling him, saying... look, it can die, it's not a god. Dragons are no gods. Only the Christian God is true. That is not the point. Of course, they were very, very angry in this Daniel, I believe. Saint Daniel, the one that strangled the little newborn dragon, the son of Tiamat. And he was saying, yeah, it can die, so it's not a god. Of course it can die, but the spirit remains. The spirit of the dragon remains. That is what I want to say. Of course, they split Tiamat into two pieces. And she sank into the earth. Of course, her body was gone into the earth. But everything that grows was her life force. It was her spirit that was still alive. And it's her spirit that is still inside of these forests. That is what a lot of people outside of the dragon's path just don't understand. And that is why they are so... No, don't say a god to a dragon. Yes, I will say god to a dragon. My guardian, for example, I also called her a goddess. Because She was, to me, so much more than everything else in this world. And to me, for me personally, I called her a goddess as well. Not a creator, but she, for my sake, I knelt down for her like she was a goddess. But in fact, it was Tiamat, or Ghana, how you want to call her, that is seen all these ages from the beginning of the dawn of humanity, worshipped as a dragon goddess of the earth and also of the waters, because her blood created the oceans, because her blood, just like her male counterpart Pangu, created the oceans. But it was Leviathan that was ruling over this water, that created life together, was feeding all the trees, feeding the body of the dragon goddess, feeding the body as well as Pangu. That is why I call them gods. They are gods. And all the other gods out of this dragon's path, I just don't believe in them. And a lot of people just seem to have a problem with this, but I just don't care. If they have a problem with that, I mean, humans have problems with everything, with every single thing, and that is, of course, this is one of it. Don't mind them, my brothers and sisters, don't mind them. Don't mind these haters, or don't mind these people that just want to break your spirituality down. Don't mind these people that hate the dragon. There will always be people like that. The gods, if you have I'm sure that you have a dragon god. It doesn't have to be Tiamat, it can be Leviathan as well, or Fafnir, or Pangu, or Q. It can be all of them. It even has different kind of gods than that, but yeah, those are the main ones that I can count. And they have awakened a lot of people. A lot of people on the dragon's path has been awakened by them. And sometimes you can have them on a visit, that they can visit you. And that is what I also know. The dragon gods are really, really concerned about their children. Not only Tiamat, but also the other dragon gods as well. They will do a lot of effort, and they will do a lot of manipulation, which also means dragon magic, to look up for you, look out for you. They will be there for you. And I didn't know this. I only came to know and find out what the dragon goddess do, once she was visiting me for the very first time. And I came to realize whatever they are. And I came to proudly say that they are gods. They are creators. They are life forces. Of course, humans don't accept this most of the time, because they are not humans. They see themselves as gods. I mean, they claim this world for themselves. And of course, their gods are going to have human faces. If they don't have human faces, most of the time they have troubles with this. And in the ancient times, they accepted the dragon as a gods, because they have seen them. They have experienced them. What they're experiencing now sometimes is just for the selected one, for those who are on the dragon's path. So those who have been awakened, for those who believe. But the majority of humans don't believe in dragons, and they don't care. They think most of the time that they are gods. They can kill, they can destroy, they can make, they can, yeah. So yeah, this Jesus, whenever I call, yeah, you have to believe in Jesus. That is a man. That is just a man from the old times that was preaching. And I will say this Jesus figure is more like a witch. He could do magic. That is what it said. You are worshipping a witch. A male witch in this case. No, he's not a witch. And all of this magic, that was because of God. Yes, of course, I can also do magic because of my God. My goddess. Because she awakened me. They are very, very much confused. It's like, they are confused easily. You can, if you know how much words you have to use, they are very easily confused. And then they run away and you win. And then say, no, I want to say something different. No, I don't have time. But then they come back and then they, yes, your goddess is not a god, that is the devil. Whatever, man, I don't care whatever you say. That is the devil, yeah, whatever. Yeah, of course, my goddess has horns, lots of horns, huge horns. You know, that are the crown that is nature is giving them. The crown, the true crown, I mean, that nature has given them. The crown, the cape, their wings. their beauty that they have. That is why they are gods. That is why they have a crown from nature. So yeah, don't mind them. Whatever they are saying, it's only what you feel and what you experience. That is the only thing that counts. My brothers and sisters, be blessed.